Welcome to the Round the League podcast.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Round the League podcast. I'm your host, Brian, and this is your podcast for everything sports. You can find this on Apple Podcasts at the Round the League podcast and on YouTube at B-Men Films. So let's go ahead and get into it. Starting off today with the NFL. Last week was week two of the NFL season, and it could be widely regarded as the week with the most injuries ever. A lot of big-name players have gotten injured, including Nick Bosa, DN for the San Francisco 49ers, who tore his ACL. Saquon Barkley did the same, tearing his ACL. Christian McCaffrey had a high ankle sprain, and he will be out for a couple of weeks. Drew Locke, the Denver Broncos quarterback, who they were really excited about and hoping that he could help bring their team to at least the playoffs or better records, he sprained his AC joint. Along with him, a wide receiver, Cortland Sutton, and their wide receiver, Jerry Jeudy. Both of them got hurt. Jerry Jeudy had a hip, and Cortland Sutton had a torn ACL, so he'll be out for the season. Jimmy Garoppolo, the quarterback for the San Francisco 49ers, had a high ankle sprain, so he will be out for, I believe, around 4 weeks. Davante Adams hurt his hamstring, along with Julio Jones, who will not be playing today. Trayvon Young had a knee injury. He's a cornerback for the Baltimore Ravens, a key part of that defense. Malik Hooker tore his Achilles. That's a very painful injury, and he will be out for at least all of this year. He's safety for the Colts. Brandon Scherff, guard for the Washington football team, hurt his knee. And Byron Jones, a cornerback for the Miami Dolphins, hurt his groin. Raheem Mostert, running back for the 49ers, sprained his MCL. Tyrod Taylor for the Chargers hurt his chest. Anthony Barr for the Vikings hurt his shoulder. And that is just getting into some of the injuries that we've had. There are tons and tons and tons more, but those are just some of the top more key ones. Some surprise games. On Monday night, the Raiders beat the Saints by 10 points at home, opening up their brand new stadium in Las Vegas. That was a huge win for the Raiders. And the Patriots lost to the Seahawks by 5. A great classic game, really, on Sunday night. Now getting into it, the Dolphins beat the Jaguars on Thursday night, 31-13. And now today, we have the 49ers and the Giants. And I will go ahead and make my picks on these. So 49ers and Giants, got to go with the 49ers. The Washington football team and the Browns, I'm going to go with Washington on this one. The Eagles and the Bengals, I'm going to go with the Bengals. The Raiders and the Patriots, I think this is going to be a very good game. I've got to go with
Raiders.
I do not like Cam Newton, and I'm a Raiders fan, I'm partially a Raiders fan. You've got the Bears and the Falcons. I'm going to go with the Bears here. You've got the Rams and the Bills. I'm going to go with the Bills here. Texans and Steelers, going to go with the Texans. Titans and Vikings, I'm going to go with the upset with the Vikings. Panthers and Chargers, I'm going to go with the Chargers. They looked really good with Justin Herbert. Jets and Colts, going to go with the Colts. Cowboys, Seahawks, always got to go with the Seahawks. They've been looking phenomenal. Buccaneers and Broncos, Buccaneers. The Lions and the Cardinals, I'm going to go with the Cardinals. Packers and Saints, Packers. And Chiefs and Ravens, this is going to be the very exciting game. Tomorrow night, Monday night at 8:15 p.m., the Chiefs and the Ravens, going to go with the Chiefs on that one. And also last week, one of the greatest comebacks in probably that will happen this year. The Falcons lost to the Cowboys by 1 point, 39-40. The Cowboys came back from being down 40-0. The Cowboys came back from being down 20-0 with after scoring a couple touchdowns. They had to get an onside kick, and they were down by 2. They got an onside kick, and they were able to get into field goal position and kick the game-winning field goal by Greg Zuerlein. Of the Cowboys, and they were able to make an extraordinary comeback. Now, in the Stanley Cup playoffs, the Stars and the Lightning are almost done. It's been a very, very, it's been a very great, very competitive series. They started off with the Stars getting the win 4-1 against the Lightning. Game 2, the Lightning got the win 2-3. And then in game three, the Lightning got the win 5-2. And then the Lightning got another win 5-4 to make the series 3-1 in Tampa Bay's favor. But then the Stars were able to get a win in two overtimes last night, 3-2. That was a very exciting game. And now, tomorrow night at 8 p.m., the Stars and Lightnings will play. Tampa Bay leads the series 3-2. So if they can get the win here, they will be the Stanley Cup champions. And if not, if the Stars get the win, we will go to a Game 7. This has been a very exciting series, and just a quick recap on it. Alrighty, now we are going to talk about college football from yesterday. SEC is finally back, and we had a very exciting day of college football. Florida, ranked number 5, beat Ole Miss, the University of Mississippi, 51-35. And then a big upset, Kansas State went in and beat Oklahoma, who was ranked number 3 for the second year in a row. This time it was in Norman, Oklahoma. So a very big win for Kansas State there. Then Kentucky and Auburn ranked number 8. And they were able to get the win over Kentucky 13-29. There was a big 100-yard pick 6 that was called back for a targeting on a defensive lineman trying to get a block, which had nothing to do with the play. But going into halftime, Kentucky was actually only down by 2 points. Auburn had gotten a 2-point conversion, and the score was 7-9. It was only down by 2 points, and I believe the score was 6-8. And then Louisiana Lafayette, who is not a team that you see ranked a lot, but they were ranked number 19, and they were able to squeak out a win against Georgia Southern, 18-20. We had a thriller in overtime with number 8 Texas and unranked Texas Tech. This one went into overtime. Texas scored 2 times in the last minute, and then they were able to squeak out the win 63-56 in overtime. Huge upset, the defending national champions, the LSU Tigers, ranked number 6, lost to Mississippi State by 10 points, 44-34. Mississippi State set a record with 623 yards of offense, which is absolutely crazy. That's Mike Leach's new offense at Mississippi State. They throw the ball a lot more, and they had a very explosive game. So watch out for Mississippi State, and LSU is not quite what they were last year. We have Georgia and Arkansas. Georgia came in ranked number 4, a very strong team, last year, but they lost their starting quarterback Jake Fromm to the draft, and then they got a transfer Jamie Newman in, and he opted out of the season. So now they had to start Stenson Bennett, and they went into halftime down 7-3 to a pretty terrible Arkansas team, but they were able to run away with the win in the second half, 37-10. They went in halftime with a very unusual score. The score was 5-7. Arkansas was up. Georgia got a safety and a field goal. Then number 2 Alabama rolled over Missouri in Missouri, 38-19. The score would have been lower, but there was a last-second touchdown by Missouri. And then in a big rivalry game, or at least what has been a big rivalry game, Florida State lost to number 12 Miami, 52-10. That was a huge win for Miami, and Florida State's really not what they used to be. And Vanderbilt almost beat number 10 ranked Texas A&M, 12-17. But A&M was able to squeak out the win. That's not a good sign for Texas A&M, trying to build up a more powerhouse school in the SEC. Almost losing to Vanderbilt is not very good. Number 16 Tennessee beat South Carolina 31-27. South Carolina had a huge defensive stand, and they were getting the ball back on a punt, but a well-executed rugby-style punt, which is where you roll out and you kind of kick it to roll. For Tennessee, it rolled up against one of the players that was blocking for South Carolina. It hit off his leg and was recovered by Tennessee. Tennessee was able to run out the rest of the clock, and they were able to get the win 31-27. That's a very unfortunate loss for South Carolina. And that is just about it for this week. Next week, two games that will be very exciting. Number 10, Texas A&M versus number 2, Alabama. These are the rankings for right now. I believe a new poll will be coming out, I don't know, maybe Tuesday, Monday, something like that. That could be a very exciting game. That will be the first game at Bryant-Denny Stadium. Number 8, Auburn will go into Sanford Stadium to play number 4, Georgia. And that's where College Game Day is going to be. So those are two of the more exciting games for college football next week. Now let's move on to the MLB. Moving into the MLB, for their expanded playoff of 16 teams this year, they're going to be doing bubbles for all of the next rounds for the National League Divisional Series. They will have it at Globe Life Field in Arlington, Texas, and Minute Maid Park in Houston. For the ALDS, Petco Park, and Dodger Stadium. For the NLCS, it will be at Globe Life Park, and the ALCS will be at Petco Park. And then for the World Series, it will be at brand new Globe Life Field in Arlington. So those are just a couple, those are the stadiums that they're going to do for the playoffs to help with the control of the coronavirus. Quarantine for players and families will begin 1 week before the playoffs start to make sure that they are virus free if they do have it by any chance, to make sure that they are virus free. Having people in the park is still up in the air. There's a chance that it could happen, but then again, there's also a chance that it couldn't, so that's still kind of up in the air. We don't know about that much. Now to finish it up, we are just going to quickly talk about the NBA. The finals has been clinched by the Los Angeles Lakers. Every single series that they've played in, they've won 4-1, including this latest one against the Denver Nuggets. Including this latest one against the Denver Nuggets, so they have clinched and will be moving in to the finals, looking to win another title. And the Miami Heat and the Boston Celtics have been locked into a very interesting series. And the Heat Heat are leading the series 3-2 against Boston. There will be going into a Game 6 very soon, and then if Boston's able to win Game 6, they will go into a Game 7 to see who will move on to the finals. So that about wraps it up for this week's edition of the Around the League podcast. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Bye!
Thanks for tuning in to the Around the League podcast. You can tune in next Wednesday for another episode.